I'm sure many of you have heard of Notch, the creator of Minecraft. Initially treating Minecraft as a small project he was working on for fun, it blew up and took the world by storm. He founded Mojang, the company still primarily in charge of the game today, and then would sell the rights to the game to Microsoft, making around $2.5 billion in the process. In just 5 years, he went from being unknown to being one of the most well-known game developers in the world. And even though he has been involved in some controversies throughout the past few years, he still remains well-known throughout the gaming community. But this video isn't about Notch. Well, not him personally. A few weeks back, I made a video about the story of the giant, where I talked about the mob and its many changes throughout the years. In that video, I discovered that Notch, the creator of Minecraft, had an old YouTube channel, of which he had many videos displaying his development of the game and some features which he was playing with. I found it really interesting, almost like a video journal of his game development and progress, and as I looked into it more, I realized that the videos he had were some of the first, if not the first, ever Minecraft videos, and they also showcased some features which never made it into the game in the future. So I thought that it would be interesting to talk about some of these videos today, and how the features showcasing them changed the game, or how they could have if they made it to Minecraft's final versions. Today's video is slightly different, but without further ado, let's get right into it. Now just quickly before I start, I need to give a disclaimer. Notch has been involved in some controversies in the past, and has said some things which people disagree with. I want to make it clear that I do not agree with what he says, and I am simply talking about him developing Minecraft, that is all. Anyways, to begin we need to talk about the channel itself. The channel was actually called Nizotch rather than Notch, and was initially created on August 11th, 2008, almost a year before Minecraft's first version was made public. Now, here's the thing. No videos are public on his channel. Clicking the videos tab will just give you a message saying his channel has no videos. But the channel has over 92,000 subscribers, so it must have had some videos in the past. And that is correct. For some reason, if you find direct URLs to these videos, you'll get this message on the screen. Video unavailable. This video contains content from Nizotch. It is not available in your country. Even using a VPN and switching to countries such as America, Japan, and many more, the message still shows up. It seems that the videos are blocked in all countries. And what's unusual about this is that it's not the normal message which shows up when a video is private. This is the message you normally get when you try to watch a private video. Rather, it seems that the videos are blocked in all countries, something you used to be able to do in YouTube Studio 2 years ago, but no longer can. Why it has been blocked? Well, we may never know for sure. Anyways, while the channel has been relatively hidden to the general community, that doesn't mean the channel isn't unknown. As I mentioned, it has over 92,000 subscribers and a total of 33 million channel views, a very impressive feat, and some of the videos which I could find URLs to display that they have in the hundreds of thousands, if not millions of views. With this attention, it was pretty obvious that people would decide to download and backup or archive his videos, and that's exactly what they did. There are two channels I found which have backed up over 30 of the old videos on the Nizotch channel, both of which I will leave links to in the description. The first is a channel dedicated to doing so called Nizotch Video Archive, and the second is a channel called Internet Video Archive, which has archived Nizotch's videos and a bunch more. So now let's talk about some of the videos. But before we do, consider subscribing. Only a small percentage of you guys are actually subscribed, and it really helps me out. No pressure though. Both channels have roughly 38 videos archived, so I'm only going to talk about some of the most interesting or most notable ones. The first of which is actually the first ever Minecraft video uploaded. Well, it was actually known as Cave Game back then, and the video was originally published on May the 13th, 2009, 4 days before the game went public. The original video on the Nizotch channel actually had 10.5 million views before it was removed. It's a rather basic video of Notch showcasing a very early test version of an Infiniminer clone he is working on, as he states in the video's description. Also in the description, he stated that it will have more resource management and materials if he ever gets around to finishing it. In the short 3-minute video, the only blocks present are a form of grass and what would later become cobblestone, it seems, with very little terrain generation, mostly just a flat plain with some small holes and dips. He does eventually enter one of these holes, which turns out to be just a large messy cave consisting of only cobblestone. As he ventures deeper into the cave or hole, he eventually reaches the presumable bottom, where the ground is flat and it goes no lower. And yeah, that's all we really see in the first ever video of Minecraft, or Cave Game as it was known back then. So interestingly enough, this video displays that Notch's original inspiration for Minecraft was from a game called Infiniminer, an open source, multiplayer, block-based, sandbox building and digging game that was released on the 29th of April 2009, about 3 weeks before the first public version of Minecraft. Looking at some footage of Infiniminer, and you can see that there are substantial similarities between it and Minecraft. It would be interesting to see if Notch would have even ended up creating Minecraft if Infiniminer never existed, and it's likely that without it, Minecraft would have never been. On to our next video by Notch Now, called Minecraft Progress, originally uploaded on May the 15th, 2009. This video, interestingly enough, is the first video and probably first ever time that the game was named or referred to as Minecraft, as was previously known as Cave Game. Anyways, the video showcases one of the earliest versions of the game, which at this current date is missing and has been lost as it was never publicly released, pre-classic RD-2009-0515. According to video footage and the wiki, this version of the game added in the dirt and stone blocks, some of the game's most recognizable and core blocks still in the game to this day, and it also added in a slightly desaturated version of wooden planks, just called planks. As Notch displays, you could now place and destroy blocks, as well as select between the four different block types using the numbers 1 through 4 on a keyboard. He spends majority of the video constructing a small house out of planks and cobblestone, and hilariously enough, this is actually the first ever house built in Minecraft on record. Towards the end of the video, he also showcases the feature whereby you could click G to spawn in human mobs, a feature which was removed not too long after. So while this video may not seem as impressive at first glance, it was actually the first time that Minecraft was referred to as Minecraft, and it also contains footage of the first ever Minecraft house and showcases a version of the game which is exceedingly rare. Historical stuff indeed. The next video is, well, kind of funny. Minecraft Water Test, originally uploaded on May the 18th, 2009, is a short 4-minute video of Notch showcasing water and its physics, and oh boy, did water act interestingly. He starts off the video by digging out a small hole in the ground and connecting it to the ocean, and as he destroys the final blocks which remain between the ocean and the hole, you can see the water just teleport in, almost instantly. And it also is all source blocks by the looks of it, there was no flowing water yet. Anyways, this first version of water was quite janky and didn't spread properly, being obstructed by just a single block, even if it could spread around it. And the same thing happens vertically, it seems that water sort of loaded in, similar to how chunks do. Notch will continue experimenting with water in another video released May the 24th, 2009, only 6 days after the first, where he showcases water's ability to finally spread around blocks and corners in a more logical way, rather than just teleporting in randomly. And it seemed Notch was having a lot of fun with water that day, because only hours later, on the exact same day, he uploaded another video about it called Minecraft Huge Flood, where he floods a cave with water at an almost instantaneous rate. Very entertaining stuff. Now, water was eventually made finite, as showcased by Notch in a video originally uploaded in early January of 2010, but it's interesting to think how different the game would be if water remained like this forever. The first thought which comes to my mind is the insane griefing potential it has, as you could flood entire bases in mere seconds with just a few buckets of water, but it also makes you think how easy it would be to build an underwater base. Now, the next video is kind of odd, as it showcases a feature which was never added to the game. On May the 25th, 2009, Nizotch uploaded a video called Vertex and Color Offsets in Minecraft, which showcased, well, exactly what I said, vertexes and color offsets, making the game look very trippy. As you can see, the blocks are all wavy and at weird angles, and in confined spaces, it almost made me motion sick. Fortunately, in the original description, he states that he's not so sure about this feature, and I, along with the comments section, are thankful he came to this conclusion. It would be interesting if Notch played with this feature more, and got it to a point where it was playable, but not too offsetting, like some mods have done in modern times. It certainly would have made Minecraft a very different game than it is today, almost adding an entire new dimension to it. The next video is another world first. On May the 31st, 2009, the first ever footage of Minecraft multiplayer was uploaded by Notch in a video titled Minecraft Multiplayer Test. As you can see, the player models are rather buggy, sometimes not moving, and as Notch originally stated in the description, there were some issues with character rotation. But all in all, it was playable, and you can see other players placing blocks and building structures. Now, Notch's original video only showcased a brief few minutes of the multiplayer test, but there are other perspectives from the other players lucky enough to participate. One such player named Telkir stated that the test lasted slightly over 30 minutes, with a few crashes and restarts along the way. Even back then, he states that there were many griefers, but also incredible structures, and hilariously, the test ended as Notch had a power blackout. Interesting stuff. Now, Notch uploaded a video called Minecraft Fighting Some Spiders on October the 24th, 2009, and it's relatively self-explanatory, just him showing off the mobs and combat system. However, what's interesting is that in these early survival test versions, there was a feature which is no longer present. As you can see above his hotbar, there is the word arrows with a counter on 20. Now, I found an old survival test version which has the exact same feature, and it's cool. You spawn with 20 arrows, which you can fire instantly at any time by clicking tab, very similar to an RPG game. Now, wouldn't it be interesting if this remained a feature in the game, as it wasn't the only RPG element Notch had in the game at one point. In the video about finite water we talked about earlier, you can see that there were attack, defense, and speed stats when you opened your inventory. It seems when Notch was initially designing the game, he had a combination of sandbox elements and RPG elements in mind, and it would be very interesting to see what the game would have become, especially multiplayer, if the RPG elements remained or even became a main focus of the game. Plugins such as MCMMO have tried to replicate this, adding abilities and levels for skills and attributes, but it's relatively bare bones. If Minecraft went the RPG route, we may have had more dungeons, mobs, and even more unique weapons and weapon enchants. It would have been very interesting, for sure. One of the weirder videos on this channel is the Minecraft MD3 test, originally uploaded on December 7th, 2009, where Notch showcases MD3 rendering in the game. To put it simply, Notch added some character models from another game called Quake and made them hostile, attacking the player and moving around in quite scary ways, to be honest. We would never see these weird models again after this video. If you watch my Giants video, then the next video would probably seem familiar, but it is interesting and unique nevertheless. The original, very first test run of Giants on Minecraft, published February 4th, 2010, is one of the only videos on the internet showcasing the version of Minecraft where Giants were first added and where they could naturally spawn. The Giant was first implemented in in-dev version 0.31, 201, 002, 05, another version of the game which has been lost, and only videos and screenshots of it exist now. This means that this video here is one of the only which displays a version of the game where the Giant were somewhat functional. I talk about this more in my Giants video, but I still think that Giants could have a place in the game if they had a biome or structure designed for them and based on their size. It would make the overworld feel more dangerous or unique, as a Giant would be sort of like a mini-boss which would be tough to fight but give rare loot when encountered. Minecraft Roller Coaster, initially uploaded on June the 20th, 2010, is a special video as it was actually the first ever video used as a Minecraft trailer. On the original Minecraft.net website back in early 2010, this video would show up almost immediately, and as such, the original has 9.7 million views on YouTube. The video is pretty straightforward though, it's just Notch riding a small little roller coaster he built out of wooden planks, showcasing minecart physics. Alright, so the second to last video we're going to be talking about today is one of Notch's last, Minecraft Biome Test, initially uploaded on October the 27th, 2010. The video showcases biomes which are added not too long after the video, and Notch flies over roughly 10 different biomes in the video, stating in the description that he will spend time giving other ones unique looking features like new trees and so. However, more importantly, there is music in this video, and the music is from C418's Volume Beta, an assortment of soundtracks which wouldn't be added to the game and made public until late November of 2013, in version 1.7.4, over 3 years after this video was first uploaded. Notch's biome video featured the soundtrack C418 Biome Fest, which is appropriately named and was the first time the soundtrack was ever made present in public. And the final video today was one of Notch's last, originally uploaded on February the 21st, 2011, the Minecraft Edge Award, an award which Notch won for Best Indie Game of 2010. Now in this video, Notch just showcases the award, but something weird which I noticed is that the video says it's 3 minutes and 22 seconds in length, but the video only plays up until the 1 minute mark and then just starts infinitely loading. And both channel archives have this exact same issue with the exact same video, so it seems that the rest of the video is lost. Weird stuff. But anyways, I think that about wraps it up for today. But before we conclude this video, I'm still very interested to know why exactly Notch decided to private or remove the videos from the public eye. Was it to do with him departing Mojang after selling the rights to Microsoft? If anybody knows, please leave a comment down below. So we didn't cover all of the archive videos, as there were well over 30, and some of them were pretty boring and not that interesting. But I hope this video was entertaining to you, and I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe and follow me on Twitter, link in the description. Thank you all so much for watching.